It's now time to look at one of my favorite tools, the pen tool. This tool is so powerful. There's so much you can do with this tool. I have posted examples of good vector artists that use the pen tool, so please feel free to find some and add some to the discussions. So let's look at this tool. I'm going to undock the panel for the pen tool. This tool allows us to draw continuous curves. This tool was created by a man named Frederick Bezier. So we draw what are called Bezier curves. The pen tool allows us to plot down what are called anchor points. These are exactly that. These are points on the canvas that we can make shapes with. But with the pen tool, we have the ability to make a lot of different lines. So let's go through them all. And please, everyone, practice each one of these lines. So we can do a straight line. This line, we can add a stroke and make it a thicker line. Under the stroke panel, we can also add different ways of ending my stroke, so rounded, and so on and so forth. So there's more options under the stroke submenu. Anytime you see something that is orange, that means it's like it's selectable. It's highlighted for a reason. So that's one line I can do, which is a straight line. I can also do a curved line. So I initially drop an anchor point. You can see the little blue dot. And then further along down the line, I'm going to click again, but hold my mouse button down this time. And what this does is it puts down an anchor point with handles. So this line going across my anchor point is called a handle. This line, I'm going to remove the fill. It kind of guesses. And then I'm just going to bring down the stroke a little bit. Whoops. So I can do a curved line. Another type of line I can do is, I would call it, I guess, like a S. So I click once. I'm going to draw a curve line just like above. And then I'm going to click and then draw, put down another anchor, have my Bezier, and create handles. So this line is like an S. With my black arrow tool, I can move it around. With my white arrow tool, I have the ability to further move my anchors. So this is really important to grasp and to play around with and get familiar with. The last type of line that I can do is I'm going to click once, drop an anchor, click again, and I'm going to create handles. I'm going to hold shift on the anchor point, and you're going to see something happen. It gets rid of one of the handles. So now I'm going to click and draw another curve. And you're going to see, this time it didn't follow. It kind of reset. And this is because our handles tell us a lot about what is happening to this anchor point. So I'm going to zoom in. So this handle can control the amount of bend between my two points, as well as I can have them independent, like this case, and not affect the other line per se. So you see how in this example, this handle affects the top handle. Basically, this handle affects this line. The handle on the left side affects the left curve of the line. So in this case, this affects that one. This affects this one. If I wanted to affect that one, I would take my convert anchor point tool here and convert my anchor point into first two handles that are working together, just like the S curve. But now I can also alter one without it altering the other, without altering the other. Using the convert anchor point tool. This tool is a little tricky sometimes, but please play around with it and make sure that you're able to create all four of these lines.